Hello everyone. In today's session, we'll be learning about the axilla, also referred to as the armpit. Okay, we'll be learning this topic from the notes that we have made. Okay, so these are very concise notes in the form of the important headings as well as the diagrams. Okay, so this will help you all to read as well as retain in a much better way. Okay, so let's begin with the location of the axilla. Where is the axilla located? Yes, it is located in the region of the upper part of the arm and the chest. Okay, so read the first heading, which is mentioned. It is a pyramid shaped space between the upper part of the arm and the side of the chest. Okay, and it has apex, base, and it has four walls: anterior, posterior, medial, and lateral. Okay, you can imagine a pyramid in this region. Okay, upper part is the apex, lower part is the base, and it has got different walls. There is an anterior wall, behind is the posterior wall, towards the chest is the medial wall, and lateral wall is very narrow. The anterior and the posterior walls converge in the region of the lateral wall. Okay, let's understand each parts one by one. Apex is also referred to as cervico-axillary canal. Okay, this diagram shows the region of the apex. Here we can see the boundaries of the apex. Anteriorly it is bounded by the clavicle. Posteriorly, there is upper border of the scapula. Medially is the outer border of the first rib. Okay, so from here, neurovascular structures enter the axilla. Okay, it is a passageway between the neck and the axilla. So it is bounded by these structures that we saw. Okay, clavicle, scapula, and the first rib. Okay, then anterior wall of the axilla, it is formed by these muscles: pectoralis major, subclavius, and pectoralis minor. Okay, so to understand the anterior wall, look at this diagram. Yes, try to understand the walls of the axilla through this image. There's a horizontal section taken at the level of the axilla, and this part is anterior, this is posterior, this is medial, and this is the lateral. Okay, so anteriorly we can see the pectoralis major and the minor muscles. Okay, posteriorly we can see there is this muscle subscapularis. Okay, along with there are two muscles called as latissimus dorsi and teres major. Okay, so that posterior wall is mentioned here. Okay, medial wall, it is formed by upper 4 and 5 ribs and the corresponding intercostal space and serratus anterior muscle. Okay, we can see this muscle here, serratus anterior muscle. Okay, so medial wall is basically ribs, the intercostal space, and the serratus anterior muscle. Okay, lateral wall, it is narrow. As I've told you, the anterior wall and posterior wall, they are converging towards the lateral wall. Okay, it is very narrow, and it has got the tendon of long head of biceps in the bicipital groove and short head of biceps brachii, as well as the coracobrachialis muscle. Okay, all these things are there in the lateral wall. And this part here, that's the base of the axilla, base also referred to as the floor of the axilla. It is formed by the axillary fascia and the skin. Okay, it is bounded anteriorly and posteriorly by folds referred to as the anterior axillary fold and the posterior axillary fold. Okay, now let's understand the contents of the axilla. It contains axillary artery and its branches. Okay, the subclavian artery, when it crosses the outer border of the first rib, then its name will change as the axillary artery. Okay, so if I have to mark this artery, then this would be the subclavian artery. Okay, when it crosses the outer border of the first rib, its name will change as the axillary artery. Okay, and it has got three parts. It is divided, the three parts are divided by a muscle called as pectoralis minor muscle. Okay, so here there is a muscle called as pectoralis minor muscle. Okay, when it crosses the pectoralis minor muscle, then there is the third part. Okay, there is a first part proximal to the pectoralis minor muscle, second part is behind the pectoralis minor, and third part is when it crosses the pectoralis minor muscle. Okay, three parts of axillary artery has got specific set of branches. First part, one branch, the branch is superior thoracic artery. Second part, two branches, thoracoacromial and lateral thoracic artery. And third part, subscapular artery, anterior and the posterior circumflex humeral arteries. Okay, then just like axillary artery is there, axillary vein with its tributaries are there. There are cords of the brachial plexus, and some of the branches originate in the axilla. Okay, then axillary lymph nodes, fibrofatty tissue. One part of mammary gland comes here. right? Axillary tail of Spence, this we had discussed in the previous video. Then long thoracic nerve, intercostal brachial nerve, okay? All these nerves are there as a part of content of the axilla, okay? Now let's understand applied anatomy of the axilla. In the axilla, there are axillary group of lymph nodes, okay? So if there is infection in the upper limb, breast, thorax, upper part of the abdominal wall, the axillary lymph nodes will get enlarged because the lymphatic drainage from these regions, they first come in the region of the axillary lymph nodes, okay? Then palpation of axillary lymph nodes is an important part of the clinical examination of breast due to their involvement in the breast cancer, okay? So we had learned the cancer of the breast spreads through lymphatics, so we have to palpate for the axillary lymph nodes in that case, okay? Then next heading is axillary clearance of lymph nodes. Clearance means removal of the lymph nodes surgically, okay? In breast cancer surgery, axillary lymph nodes will have to be removed, and during this procedure, care has to be taken to avoid injury to the long thoracic nerve, thoracodorsal nerve, intercostal brachial nerve, okay? Then axillary abscess. Axillary abscess arises from the infection of the axillary lymph nodes. The pus of the abscess may track up into the neck or into the arm, okay? From the axilla, the abscess may go up towards the neck or it may go down towards the arm, okay? So in the arm, it can go through the axillary sheath or it can go between the pectoral muscles if it pierces the clavipectoral fascia, okay? In the next video, we'll learn what is this clavipectoral fascia, a small topic we'll be covering, okay? Then axillary abscess is drained by giving an incision in the base of the axilla, okay? In the region of base of the axilla, between the anterior and the posterior axillary folds, an incision has to be given for draining the axillary abscess, okay? Then there could be boils in the region of axilla. Boils are painful red bumps which are seen due to the infection of the hair follicles in the sebaceous glands. Okay, in the axilla, there are hairs which are present that sebaceous glands can get infected, and there could be pain and swelling in that region. Okay, usually an antibiotic course of medicines is required to decrease the infection. Okay, then injury to the neurovascular structures. So what is this? When the arm is abducted, the neurovascular structures are vulnerable to injury. Okay. So usually in normal anatomical position, the arm is adducted, but when the arm is abducted, then the structures, neurovascular structures, which are present in the axilla, they can get injured. Okay. So this was about the axilla. All major headings we covered with the diagram. Okay. So at least this much is required whenever a question is asked. Write specific key headings and draw 2 to 3 well-labeled diagrams, okay? So that everything which is required we have covered in these notes. Link to buy these notes, I'll put it in the description box below, okay? Thank you.